Coordinating all the jobs and tests, measurements and results routinely required for environmental protection is no small task. In the past, most facilities approached each regulation as a separate task. But recently, a new approach is being adopted, a systems approach. An environmental management system, or EMS, is a comprehensive environmental protection program that is integrated throughout an organization. The purpose of the EMS is to coordinate all environmental operations and to see that environmental objectives are integrated into operational goals. By far, the most widely used EMS is the ISO 14001 standard, an EMS structure that was developed in the mid-1990s and is now being used by tens of thousands of facilities worldwide. Whether a facility adopts the ISO 14001 or develops another EMS, the purpose is the same: to say what you're going to do. That is, to make a plan for pollution prevention. To do what you say. To execute the plan. To document what you've done. And then to improve the process by fixing any shortcomings or discrepancies. There are five main components to a complete EMS. Each one contributes to the next, making a full working cycle to achieve not only regulatory compliance today, but continual improvement in environmental performance tomorrow.
The foundation of the EMS is an environmental policy that clearly spells out the organization's commitment to the environment, to pollution prevention, to reduction of wastes, to decreased consumption of raw materials and energy, and to conformance with all applicable EMS requirements. This policy is usually signed by the chief executive. An environmental plan then builds a blueprint for action. The plan first identifies all the environmental aspects of the organization's activities, products, and services, characterizes how they interact with the environment, and determines all the legal and environmental requirements that apply to its operations. Then this information is used to set up performance objectives and a strategy for achieving the objectives and maintaining ongoing conformance with all EMS requirements.
To turn the plan into an effective, functioning process, an implementation program is developed to define organizational structures, allocate resources, and assign responsibilities. The program also sets down guidelines and checkpoints to ensure that everyone understands and carries out his or her individual duties. In many respects, implementation is where the real work gets done, where conformance hits the ground. To determine whether the implementation program is accomplishing the objectives, measurement and evaluation must be performed. All activities that have environmental impacts must be carefully monitored and accurately measured. This reveals non-conforming emissions, releases, and faulty operations or work practices. Where objectives are not being met, prompt corrective action is initiated to restore conformance.
The final responsibility is for management to review and improve the entire system. This process ensures that the system is functioning properly, that the facility is conforming to the requirements, and that there is continual improvement in environmental protection. Review and improvement can lead to changes in the environmental policy that ripple throughout the EMS to promote even better performance.